D.C. is mainly an urban area. Historically, water was treated by just the natural trees and plants, and with all the roadways and buildings, that doesn't happen anymore. When the water enters the waterway, such as Rock Creek Park, if it goes straight from the pavement, it brings everything from the exhaust coming off of cars and sediment from the ground, and that enters the waterways and it hurts the water. It hurts the fish, it hurts the quality of the water for people to fish, to swim, to drink. It erodes the channels, which then damages the plants. One of the goals of TNC is to use nature-based solutions to solve these problems.
The fundamental mission here is serving those who have served. We have a special bond with these families, and I think for me, that's incredibly important that we never let them down. The city of DC has a clean rivers impervious area charge that they assess the users of water in the city. For Knollwood, that amounted to over $300,000 by 2018. And we realize, as you look at our parking lots and the cars here and the amount of commercial traffic that comes in here, all the residue flows straight downhill into our storm drains. And we didn't know where the storm drains go. So we reached out to the Nature Conservancy because we knew they had done a similar rainwater project for other communities, nonprofits, if you will, in Washington, D.C.
This is called a bioretention facility, more commonly known as a rain garden. And basically, it captures water coming off of the roadway, the grass, the sidewalks, and the water enters the facility and it's able to pass through different layers of mulch and stone and a special media that filters out basically any contaminants or sediment that comes off in the water. And then the plants are also there to kind of help also take up any contaminants that are in the water so that by the time it leaves the garden and enters the waterway, it's cleaner than when it entered.
The Nature Conservancy really came alongside us and guided us through this entire process. From the development, they brought in some environmental engineers to develop this, and they did it all at their own cost. They got the permitting approved, the entitlements and the permitting approved with the city. They provided the oversight of the contractor throughout the entire process, and they do the maintenance. So for us, it was perfect.
I think everybody welcomed it when Colonel Bricker announced that we were going to do this. It was a nice open space, but to enhance it with the garden, just as open space, and to have the water cleaning as another component of that, I think that was people supported that very much around here. We have a lot of people involved in gardening, and in taking care of the community, and this is another opportunity for them to use their talents.
So these types of projects can also help with urban heat island. The plants can provide habitats for different birds and insects.
It's a win-win. It's a win because we can help protect the environment, and it's a win because it lowers our expenses here for our residents and overall for the foundation that runs Knollwood. So we want the community to see this because we think this can be a wonderful example for other nonprofits and other communities. And if it helps one community do this, then it's worthwhile.